breaking news about how buffs work in Rise of Kingdoms, ladies and gentlemen. Commander like Constantine, Joan of Arc, Mulan, William, the new Trian. You definitely want to know how they are actually working in a mortar ball, because this is mind-blowing what I'm going to share with you in this video, and this is definitely going to change your perspective of how you're making your marches or how you are creating your marches in Ark of Osiris for the murder board for the middle, thanks to Dragotin. So I want to give him credits, because that's where everything is coming from. How does all these buffs are really working in Rise of Kingdoms? Hello everyone, and welcome back to another Rise of Kingdoms video. My name is Legend Ronnie, and today I have a really hot topic for you all that we need to discuss about. Like I was mentioning at the beginning of the video, breaking news, mind-blowing news, however you want to call them. All the credits goes to Dragotin, because he started all this about the buffing commanders like Trian, Constantine, Mulan, Joan of Arc, William, and whoever else does work in your murder ball or when it's more than a certain amount of marches. And I'm going to put a link in the description of my video if you want to check the original video that Dragotin made. How it all started, he made a commander mastery, like I make commander spotlights about Trian, and he had a comment in the comment section of the video about Trian not buffing only 5 marches, not buffing the entire murder ball, right? Which it is really crazy, it's really mind-blowing. So what Dragotin done, he asked the devs, the support, or whoever he has in contact to confirm if that is true. And they confirmed that it is true. And Dragotin asked, all right, so when was this updated into the game that all these AoE buffing commanders only work up to 5 marches, up to 5 allied marches? And they said that this was working forever. So this is, for me, is really mind-blowing, because I'm playing this game for 3 years and I didn't know that. I didn't know that commanders like Joan of Arc only goes up to 5 marches. It doesn't specify. And there is one commander that does specify and is the only one. And this is why it's so crazy, because it's probably the most least used commander, or maybe if we include gathering. Cleopatra, on her primary skill, it specifically says that only up to 5 marches. So whenever someone was asking me, should I bring Cleopatra on the murder ball for buffing, I always said no. Why do you want to bring a commander in a murder ball that only buffs up to 5 marches, when you can bring commanders that can buff the entire murder ball, like Joan of Arc? So for 3 years, I played this game knowing that Constantine, Joan of Arc, Mulan, William, Trian, and whoever else is that does AoE buffs, they all work on all the marches. And there was another question that Dragotin asked. I said, okay, so if it only buffs 5 marches, then how does it actually work? And the answer was that it's random. So how about that? Meaning that you can have 5-10 Joan of Arcs in a murder ball, and you can have a chance that all those buffs might go on just one march. And obviously only one of the buffs works. And you can have 100 marches in the murder ball that might not get any buffs. Well, it depends on the placements of the Joans, because, you know, when is a lot of marches, a big murder ball, but as an idea. And personally, I think that AoE commanders are starting to have a much higher role in the murder balls rather than bringing a lot of buffing commanders. I'm super shocked of all this, and definitely needs some testing, and I hope I can see some videos about some more YouTubers or at least someone who's doing a proper test to know 100% sure. My plan was, when Trian was being released, to go ahead and just max kill him, because we're going in KvK and he really has a unique buff. According to the wheel changes that should be in about 2-3 weeks, I will be able to select Trian and work on him. It doesn't matter that he's not yet released in my kingdom, because it's not gonna work like that anymore. I've done a video about it, how MG and Will are working. I'm probably gonna post a card on the top about it. Right now, I kind of changed that perspective and that idea, because I definitely not gonna max him out. I'm definitely gonna put him on a second, third back seat. I'm gonna have a lot of second thoughts and third thoughts if I'm going to max him. And what I suggest that should be brought now in the murder balls, commanders like Nebuchadnezzar, commanders like Harald, commanders like Sun Tzu, commanders that do a crap ton of AoE damage. William, he hits 3 targets, is still AoE and buffs in the same time. Then you have Leonidas, you have Guan Yu. If you don't have all of these, you can even bring a Max Mehmet, Artemisia, 100%. Then you have Aethelflaed and Richards, you have YSGs, as many YSGs as possible. And you're probably saying, why Richards and Aethelflaed? Well, because these two commanders have fan-shaped area. So when you look at Aethelflaed, it says on her primary skill, forward-facing fan-shaped area, and same on Richard, and they are debuffs. They are very strong and powerful debuffs. These commanders can be always positioned in different ways, meaning that there is a whole lot of marches that they can debuff. So it's a very small chance that the same Richards or the same Aethelflaed will debuff the same target. That's why I would say that as many Richards and Aethelflaeds as possible. I would definitely bring a couple of Constantines, but I still think that AoE damage and AoE debuff might be the best way to go in the murder balls right now, rather than bringing AoE buffs. That's just my thoughts, but a lot of tests need to be done. And this is kind of changing a lot about Ark of Osiris as well, regarding Constantine's Joan of Arc and all this. Again, this is all mind-blowing breaking news for me as well. So let me know in the comment section below, what do you think about these changes? Because I'm speechless. I'm really, really speechless. How does these commanders only buff 5 marches and they don't have it on their description? I mean, the RNG right now in Rise of Kingdoms, knowing this, is probably the highest RNG in any game I have ever played. If this is random how the buffs goes in a murder ball, like I was mentioning, possible that one march can get 10 buffs, is really crazy. We definitely need to have a discussion in the comment section below, because again, this is mind-blowing and this is really crazy. I hope that a lot of tests will be made and more videos will come out about this. People need to know. Make sure you share. Until next time, this is your boy Jeroni signing off. Peace out, yo, and take care. See you in the next one, and stay safe out there, my friends.